I think since he's the creator of this thing, I think it might have made more sense for him to be Warp Room 4, the Warp Room 4 boss, but I don't know. I guess, well, I'm not going to say who it is yet, because you probably already know, because this is a freaking old game by this point, and loads of people have played it, but I just like to be spoiler-free in my playthroughs as much as possible. But yeah, I guess they just wanted to have like a thing going on with the... Well, I can't even say anything without spoiling it, so I guess I'll just leave it for now. But here we go. We have not Yoshi. Basically, he has a he can just run into boxes. Has a much smoother jump than Crash does, and he can basically jump as far as high. I think it's higher than even a double jump, even a slide double jump. I could be wrong, but it feels like that. But yeah, it's just kind of a random thing, I guess. Okay, I guess you gotta have some dinosaurs. You only have the pterodactyls, the triceratops, and then you have those weird spinning things. And let's see if this works. Oh. I think I went backwards. Actually, I'll undo that again. I want to see that. Because if you, there's a way where you can, like make the... Yeah, there you go. That's amazing. I wonder if they're gonna keep that in. Oh man, I'm so excited. Like, there's so much to look forward to. Like, there's, what was it? Like, there's obviously, like, Kingdom Hearts 3 is not going to be for a good amount of time. Like, I'm expecting, like, holiday 2018 at the earliest. But it would be fun if I could get him, like, make him pop out again and, like, amazingly screw up the level. But, yeah, it's weird though, like, it doesn't, it just kind of pops up now, because the thing's gone. But, yeah, the little Triceratops is good buddy, because he takes care of the boxes for us, and it does count. Alright, this level can actually be pretty tricky. So, already getting this little sub-tank thing. Where can I do this? Oh, I can! Well, I guess later on you have to touch with Crash, so I guess that makes sense. I think there's a nitro box at the end that you can use, but I'm just gonna destroy them just in case. But yeah, there's a detour at the end of the level we're gonna make if we're gonna wanna get the colored and the box gem. But yeah, one thing that that Crash 2 I guess has going for it is the fact that Crash 2 with the colored gems had it so you can go through the game and you'll get the colored gems as you go through, so and then you'll have it so you don't have to backtrack to earlier warp rooms to get all the gems or anything like that. Now, in Crash 3, there were times when you had to go to and get a colored gem all the way in warp room 5 in order to get something like way earlier on in the game. And I guess that... And I guess that can be kind of a nuisance for some. I don't mind it too much because the warp room's really small anyway. And I tend to do... I tend to just go through the regular game first, get to Cortex, and then do the optional stuff that I couldn't do before. Then, when you do that, it just becomes much more streamlined, in my opinion. But just go! Oh my gosh, I thought I got sucked in. I'm not gonna get that checkpoint, because... Slow down, please. Because... We're gonna have to go back. So I wanna get the stuff from here, go back, then get the checkpoint so I don't have to do this stuff again. Kinda like the, one level in Crash 2. I think it was one of the space station levels. Stay far away, because this guy gives me a second hitbox. Alright, get rid of you. Oh my gosh. Look at that! We're missing 31 boxes. So, what's up with that? Okay. I probably shouldn't do so. Okay, we're good. We can die all we want. Well, not necessarily, because otherwise we'll have to get a game over and restart a level, but... Yeah, that section isn't an issue for us. Now I can go to a secret area here. And I guess you could... Okay, that was a fail. I guess you could kind of count this as a death room. Like, it really depends, it really depends what you count as a death room, because there's obviously, like, the main actual death rooms you go through, but there are areas that, like this, that kind of can be considered death rooms, because you have so much more challenging obstacles here. Alright. Don't have the, okay, no. Yeah. Those sections like that are a lot more dangerous than, you might think. Alright, that's all good. No, this isn't too bad, just time it and then you're good. And, there we go. Both gems. Both gems and the crystal. I love the item collecting sound, by the way. So satisfying. Alright, now this is gonna be interesting, because I remember like having a pretty hard time doing time trials with this stage personally. Okay. Oh, I'm not accepting that. I'm going back. I don't remember a good strategy for this one, so this might be kind of hard to do. Wait, okay, can I destroy the TNT and go back and get the clock? Yes, I can. Please don't come back. Man! Dang it, okay, whatever, I'm going. I'm keep going. Yeah, like, that's basically your faster mode of transportation. Just spam the spin. Just gonna have to. Dang it. I really shouldn't have taken that hit. No. That thing goes. That, yeah, that thing stays out for longer than you'd expect. Alright. Don't go too far in, because I think if you do, the clock will just spawn out. Alright, got the two Akus. It's all good. Whatever. I can do it. I should be able to get it without that time box. You can afford to miss some. Alright. Still got one. Still got one mask. But I don't want to lose it to these guys. So that would be really sad. Have to take the hit. Thank you. That was kind of slow. Alright, go up here. Alright, I don't know how. Come on, Crash, what you. If that that probably costed me my gold. I'm gonna be so upset if that's the case. Oh my gosh. And we missed that. Yeah, we haven't gone. We haven't got it. Let's see. I missed too much. What? How? I mean, I'm not complaining, but how was that a platinum? I missed so many time boxes. Okay. See yourself. Cool. I don't even know what to say about that, man.
So, you pesky little rats aren't going to back off, eh? Just you continue to gather crystals and see what I do.
And, yeah, like, it's still, you can still tell it's like PS1 standards, but, like early gaming industry and standards and all that, but for its time, Crash 1 and, well, not Crash 1. Crash 1's pretty meh for that, but the animations and the lip syncing and the voice acting are actually pretty decent for, like, when this game came out in, like, 1998, maybe? Like, Crash 1 was 96, and they made one every year, I believe. So I'm gonna say this is 98. But yeah, for the time, this is actually very, very good voice acting and very good animations. Like, they actually make sure it's properly lip-synced and all that. And you can still tell it's, like, PS1 standards. And they are, there are only a few fully animated cutscenes, and there's all the other stuff is just floating heads. And that's, I'd say, I don't know the first thing about animation. And I know that it takes a long time, but I want to say that just animating floating heads is a lot easier than, like, full body movements and, like, all that stuff. And you don't have to worry about the environment or anything like that. You just have, well, you just have that floating circle teleporter thing for all of them. You just make that once and you're good. But, yeah. I think this stage has this is gonna be dangerous. Yeah, screw it. I'm not even gonna take any chances. Oh. Okay, I'm just gonna do this. Thank you, Shockwave. But yeah, like, people compare, like, some people I have compared, like, this, the animation quality and the voice acting to that of the Sonic Adventure games. And I'm not saying, oh yeah, there's a death ray over there. I'm not saying that the Adventure games have amazing voice acting or animations or anything like that. But you have to keep in mind that you're talking about entirely different games here. And the fact that the Crash games only have a few cutscenes, and it's mainly, the main focus is like the actual, like, the actual gameplay. Yeah, who would have thought? Okay. Yeah, that's actually kind of difficult to time. But yeah, like, Sonic Adventure 1 and 2, you have to keep in mind... I hate that. You have to keep in mind that there's a lot to the adventure games, and there are so many cutscenes, and it's not just flowing heads, it's full body animations. And going back to SA1, like, yeah, the animations are quite lazy, but you have to keep in mind, even then, it's one of the first games to do something like that. Like, and to the extent of SA1, because there aren't many games before then that had that many cutscenes that are fully animated. Dang it. So, keeping that in mind, like, SA1 is pretty amazing for its time. And SA2, while the animation is pretty subpar by today's standards, for its time, it was actually decently... I'd say it's decently put together. And I actually kind of like the... I was too impatient there. For its time, I'd say Sonic Adventure 2 had decent animations. And I actually kind of like the voice acting. It's not, like, great, but I do like the voices. With the exception of Tails. I'll get more into this when I actually do SA2. I have a lot to say about that game. But yeah, like, I will still say, like, the Crash games had pretty good animations. Like, what? Okay. Hitboxes, what are those? I don't understand what happened there. Oh man. But yeah. Like, I'm not saying the Crash games had bad animations, because they really don't. They have really great animations. But I think it's a little bit exaggerated. And we're doing, just like Crash 2, we're doing a death warp, so we can get both gems. Oh, we can replay the level, but what's the fun in that? Because we're going to have to do it again anyway. Time trial later on. Also, another thing, you can't body slam after you do a double jump, so... Or a slide jump for that matter. Okay. I could try doing the slide trick again on that, but I'm not going to. I tried spinning, I swear. I should gonna try it. Oops. Oopsie. Alright, let's just do it normally. Boy. Alright. Thank you, hitboxes. Yeah, we're coming up to the end here. Booyah! I believe that's our first color gem. Oh, right, I forgot about Deep Trouble. Okay. Second motorcycle level. Alright, I'm not gonna go for it now, but once you see an alien sign in this stage, that's actually a portal to a secret level. So, you know how Crash 2 you had like these secret areas, these areas that magically made you walk to the secret walk room and opened up a extra part of a level or a state or a new stage entirely? It's basically the same. Well, it doesn't take you to the secret walk room, but it basically brings you to two completely new levels. And you don't necessarily have to do them if you want to get the true ending, because once you go to them, I think the gem counter goes up by one or two or something like that. So, you know, you don't actually have to go to them if you want to get 100%. Well, did I get all those? I couldn't tell. I shouldn't say 100%, because you do want to get that thing, or 105% in this game's case, I think. You have to get all the gold relics and all the gems in every stage, but either way, there's a gem, a box even. Come on, yes. I want to see if I can get the crystal as well. It looks like I'm not going to, but... Maybe. Yeah, no, I needed that boost. I needed the boost. Might still have a chance. If we're good enough. Nah. I don't know if you can, but it looks like I was gonna miss it. Alright, I'm gonna have to play that stage two times, I guess. Or two more times. Yeah, don't dance, we're not done yet. Yeah. Man. Gonna act like I'm doing the time trial now, I guess. Just kinda hug the sides as much as possible. And you want to make sure that you don't, if you want to keep up your speed, try your best not to, like, make the motorcycle, like, drift to the side too much, like, when it makes a screeching, or whatever, that greatly decreases your speed, so you want to avoid that. And the ramps don't give you a speed boost at all, so you don't... Only do it if there's a bottomless pit. And it also, if you have a boost on, it immediately cancels it. Oh, come on! What?! I'm seeing all kinds of crap today, like, what is this? Yeah, thank you, Sign. want to avoid that. Oh, thanks. No. Alright. Come on. If we can't even get the crystal, there's no way we're gonna be able to get the gold relic. Oh, come on, really? Am I really failing it again? Oh. This isn't hard. Theoretically, anyway. It would have been hilarious if I pressed the wrong button. Alright, let's try this again. Cars jumping up like that, that's so weird. Whoa, okay. Yes. Okay, let's see how this goes, because I'm not confident, to be honest. Why is this taking me so long? Maybe. Yes! That took way too freaking long, and I barely even got it. I believe this is the last medieval level.
Well, you've crashed a few parties before, but I never expected you to make it this far. If you don't turn back, I will inflict 1,000 years of suffering on you and the entire universe!
Okay. Yeah, now we have the thunderstorm going on. Also, just to show it off. I wonder how they're gonna reanimate that. Booyah! Yeah, these guys actually gave me a lot of trouble as a kid. Like those, their hitbox is really large, and as you'd expect, because it's all about timing. Just watch out for the time periods, or they aren't swinging their clubs. Bro. Oh. Okay. Thanks, lingering hitboxes. I just like how they put one right up in your face at the start. Okay. But yeah, you can't actually kill them, they just get knocked out. Okay, be careful there. But yeah, honestly, I find this stage a lot more difficult than half the things in Crash 2. Like, the enemies are pretty difficult to avoid. Like, I'd say overall the enemies are a lot more difficult to deal with in this game. The only exception I can think of are the scorpions being easier than those little machine things in the sewer levels, because you can't kill the things in the sewer levels, but you can kill the scorpions. Other than that, though, I think the enemies are a lot harder to deal with, personally. Like, you have stuff like the goat that are just kind of walking around, they're like the goombas, more or less. And they aren't hard to deal with at all, but they're infrequent. And again, the wizards in the other, like these wizards, again, if you don't know, you could spin attack the spells away. They're some of the hardest enemies to avoid. Well, I wouldn't go that far, but they are pretty annoying. It's pretty fun to do it, jumping part away from the spells, because it feels like an obstacle course. But either way. Alright. Now, fun fact actually, I think in the beta version there was a bonus room in one of these medieval stages that was like Crash 2, where you had to use the slam ability that makes you go to a ground section or something. That would have been pretty interesting to see, and hopefully... Dang it. Actually, maybe I can still get those. Come on. This is not gonna work, is it? Yeah, no, it's not gonna work. Okay. But yeah, like, I guess going to, like, just for childhood and all that, like, this is, I didn't have the most expensive library on the PS1, or the N64, for that matter, but, you know, you make do with what you have back then. You don't, can't always, like, afford to have, like, tons of games and tons of consoles. But yeah, like, I played the crap out of this game as a kid. Like, I played this game, like, more times than I can remember, honestly. Yeah, excuse me. And, I don't know, like, it's funny how I went through the series, because I went Crash 3, and then I went back to Crash 1, and then I kind of dropped out of the series for a long time, because I lost the games, I didn't necessarily lose them, but they were given away, and all that. I forget all the major details about it, but it's not really important at this point, but yeah, like, that happened. I couldn't play a Crash game for the longest time, and then I wasn't even aware. Well, I was aware of the tie-ins games at the time. I've been aware of those games for ages, but I didn't actually know about Ralph or Cortex. I think I was aware of Twinsanity, but yeah, I wasn't really fully aware of Ralph or Cortex existed at the time. So one day, I think my sister just bought the game wanting to play Crash, and then, yeah, I played that, and then I got 1 and 3 again, and then I got Crash 2, I think, at a convention or something, a boxed copy, and then I found out that it froze on one of the Road to Ruin, I believe it was. So I got the PSN copy, and then I played Twinsanity, and then the Titans games. I think that's the timeline.
Understand what you're getting yourselves into. This time, you've done it.
He said time. But yeah, I think that's the Crash timeline, or how I played the games.
Now you're on my time, you little skunk. Give me the crystals.
Alright, so this boss is basically, he's gonna shoot out some orb things, some heat wave thingamabobs, whatever these are meant to be, and he'll eventually get tired and change the platforms into a obstacle course to get to him, for some reason. Like, if you're tired, just make sure you don't pound the ground with that fork thing of yours. Like, you should learn by the first time that, oh, I shouldn't do this because it's going to change the platforms. Like, bruh. I guess he's hoping that I fall, but hey, I'm Crash Bandicoot, man. Alright. Yes, I'd say overall this is probably the easiest boss in the game, although he can trick you up on this last section, because he does that twice. Alright. And you're done. So, my copy is messed up. He's supposed to say, my time's up, but soon yours will be too, or something like that, but for some reason my copy just glitches out there.
You insolent, insignificant morons! By defeating Entropy, you have placed us all in grave risk! Christ, Coco, you must realize that this time twister machine is very delicate. Without Dr. Entropy's constant care and control, who knows what it will do?
Who knows indeed.